Greetings and welcome back to my channel for another video in the Dynamo for Advanced Steel series. Today, we will cover another cool script that will allow you to create your own type of a staircase with a special type of step that can't be made with the standard Advanced Steel macro. The script looks like this. It may seem a bit intimidating, but we will break it down and I will teach you how to create similar scripts for your projects. First, let's take a look at the staircase we will be getting for creating it in the model. We will need to specify two points just like we do when inserting a macro with standard Advanced Steel tools. We select the starting point, click Change, switch to the model and specify the snap, then return to Dynamo. We click Change again and specify the top point. Then, we click the Run button. The staircase is created and we can take a look at the model to see what we've got. This is the staircase we get. The unusual thing about it is the steps. There is a frame made of an angles that is covered with grating. Now, let's take a look at the properties given to the elements. Aside from the geometry being created, you can also assign a predefined material and model role to the elements. Let's take a look at the node groups here. Firstly, there's an input group where we set the main parameters. That is, the stringer beam section, the step beam section, the distance between stringers, the role and material of the stringers, and the number of steps. We also specify what the grating will look like, that will cover the steps, including its section and the offset from the edge of the step. To understand how the script works, let's try to create it step by step. On the first step, we need to create the stringers. When we select the insertion points, we are essentially determining how the red line will be positioned. However, we don't actually have any elements along this red line. We need to shift this line to the left and right using vectors to obtain two stringers. We get two lines parallel to the line we specified by the points, and then assign beam properties to these lines, such as the beam section, material, function, mirroring, and so on. Let's try to understand how this works. First, we take a line by its start and end points, which we also use to create a vector that we will need later on. To transform the line, to move it somewhere, we need to use this node called geometry translate. But to use it, we need to specify the direction in which we are moving the line and also the distance, the value by which we are shifting this line. The most difficult part is finding the right vector since we initially specify two points and this vector which can be directed in any way. That is, we need to obtain a certain central plane of this staircase, and then find a normal vector to this plane. Our first vector will be the vector along the staircase, and the second vector will be the Z vector, which is always pointing upwards. This is how we get the plane we need. From geometry, you may remember that any two non-collinear vectors will always form a single plane. Then we use the vector cross node, which essentially finds the normal vector for the two previously entered vectors. All that's left is to enter the offset distance, which is half the width of the staircase. Here, it is written as width of the stair divided by 2 for the positive direction and minus width of the stair divided by 2 for the negative direction. To avoid creating a vector directed in the opposite direction, we simply change the sign of the distance to negative, and this will shift the line in the opposite direction. This way, we get two lines at the output, and then we need to turn these two lines into standard straight beams. This is much easier. We create properties, specifically, one of the first properties for the beam that we need to create is alignment. We will align it to the upper left point. Let me demonstrate this in the model on the positioning tab. We need precisely this point to align the stringer. Next, we need to specify the beam section. It is indicated using two parameters, section type and section size. Essentially, this is the beam standard and beam section. We also create material properties in the same way. We set the value for it as steel 235, and we also create a property for the function and assign it a value of stringer. So, we now have three additional properties. For the alignment property, we directly send it to the node using which we create the profile along the line. Here, there are separate input blocks for the reference axis, and for the other properties, we create a list since we only have one input. Another feature is that for the second stringer, in addition to everything else, we also need to mirror the section since the flange of the channels will face different directions. Therefore, we add a cross-section mirror to mirror the section accordingly. Let's try to apply this script and see what we get. We run it and we should get two stringers. Let's move on. Here, we will try to add steps. Firstly, we will only create the front face of the step, meaning we will only create one angle beam. To create the steps, we need to divide the line into equal segments. We can do this using a node called points at equal segment length. We will take one of the stringer lines as the line and take the specific value that we added in the step settings as the number of divisions, i.e., the number of segments. We have properties for step width, step section, standard, and the actual section size. As for the number of steps, although we have set it as 10, there will actually be 9 steps because there are 10 segments, and there will be one less step than the number of segments. Keep this in mind. Next, we need to correctly position this angle beam. We need it to be oriented horizontally relative to the surface and not tilted in the plane of the stringers. There are probably different ways to achieve this, but I decided to do it in the simplest possible way. I will simply remove the Z component from the vector that I previously calculated. This vector, which I obtained from two points, is directed along the stringer. So, by removing its Z component, I obtain a vector that is projected onto the plane, ensuring that the step is always horizontal. I take the X and Y components of this new vector to create another vector that will determine how the cross-section is oriented in the model, regardless of the position of the staircase. This way, no matter which two points we used for the orientation in space, we will always obtain the correct placement of the angle beams on the steps. Next, we just need to connect the points we obtained at the beginning and at the end. After we have input the points and orientation of the beam, we just need to specify the alignment of this beam to the bottom left corner. We add properties for the stairs just like we did for the stringers. We add the property name, set its value through two variables for standard and cross-section, and add its model role. We then combine all of this into a list. Let's see what we've got. For this, we will have to specify the points each time because they reset when the script is opened. This is a bit inconvenient, but what can you do for the sake of art? Click Run, and we have our transverse profiles. Everything is as intended. We move on to the next iteration. Here, we need to add the back face of the steps. We will do this using the Geometry Translate node. We will move the line that we have already obtained from the front face. Here, everything is quite simple in terms of direction. We can use the same vector that we applied to the front profile to orient the angle section. Along same direction, we remove the Z component. We will move the back face by the width of the step, which is the same 200 mm specified in the input block. We will also use the cross-section mirror node. This beam will be mirrored and connected to the same node to avoid creating new ones. We run the script. We've got two beams, now we need to create two more beams to get a frame. So we can keep the same properties for angle beams. The only thing we need to do is to obtain different points, but actually, we already have the necessary points because we have obtained the beginning and the end of the front and back edges. These will be the initial and final points of the lateral edges of the steps. To do this, we take the initial point on the curve and connect the initial point of the front face to the initial point of the back face. We do the same for the second lateral edge by connecting the final point of the front face to the final point of the back edge. We use these points to determine the direction of the orientation of the cross-section. We obtain two vectors and connect them to the node. Let's see what we've got now. We have four angles that will be arranged in a rectangular contour. Now we need to add the cuts. There are several important points about the cuts. First, the cut of the profiles will be zero because we are not shortening the profiles. We cut the profile at a 45-degree angle. The angle of the cut needs to be specified in radians, it's pretty easy to calculate. And we will need to create a total of 8 cuts. Step cut, value 0, is a shortening. This is a 45-degree angle which is recorded in radians, plus 45 and minus 45, respectively. We will need both options here. This is a node that defines a cut at a specified angle. There is one property so that we don't end up with a bunch of features later. This is the object display mode. We will need to turn off the display of features so as not to clutter the model. Here we specify which element we are cutting and specify the value, which in this case will always be 0. We also specify additional parameters that we input through a list. The first parameter is the cutting angle that we specify, and the second parameter is the display type. For the display type, we also have a value of 0 specified. This disables the display of features. This block will create all the cuts that we will need to fit the corner pieces around the step. We have obtained all the 45-degree cutouts, and the green frames of the features are disabled. Let's consider the next step. On it, we will create a cover for the step and immediately run the script. A covering was created. As you can see, it is specified with a certain indentation, and this is the main difficulty. Now we will figure out how to do this if we already have the main points, the points that are located at the corners of the step. We create them using four lists. We take the lines that form the step and select their first points. This gives us four sets of points, one for each corner of the step. We combine them into four lists, which can be seen here. We need to transpose these lists because we need to get separate lists that outline each step. To do this, we use a node called transpose. This gives us each step made from points. Next, we need to convert all of this into a polyline, or in Dynamo terms, a polycurve. Then we apply a node called curve offset, which allows us to move away from this polyline by a distance of 10. This value is set in the input block for the floor settings. Here it is set to minus 10, which means we will be moving inward. But there is one caveat. To build the grating, we need not a polycurve, but a polygon. We need to turn this polyline into a so-called polygon. This can also be done using several nodes, including one that separates the polyline into individual lines. Then we will use a node that takes starting points and builds polygons based on these starting points. This will give us 9 polygons, which are actually built from the same points as the polylines, but with an offset. Then we load all these parameters into a node that creates a grating by the polygon. Additional parameters are used here, including a function. As a result, we get not only a step but also a cover on top of it. Now let's take a look at the final version. In the final version, in addition to everything else, a weld will also be created. In general, the weld is created quite simply. We select the weld point node, and in this node, we need to load the point where we will place this weld. This is not essential, I just take a point on the stringer. The most important thing is to choose the objects to be connected by the weld. We select objects by creating a list. I choose all the stringers, steps, and other elements. There is only one inconvenience, unfortunately, for some reason, this node cannot attach the grating. It can attach a plate, for example, but not a grating for some reason. Therefore, our grating will remain hanging as it is. And one more property that we need to specify for the weld is that our weld will be a factory weld, i.e., in shop 1. I also wanted to show that you can replace the grating on the steps with plates. Let's try to do that. We turn off the grating, connect the plates, and add another slot here to include the plates. Now we can press the run button. So now we have replaced the grating with plates, and we can also check how all this is connected. Everything is okay, and now we can add various feed utes, steel connections, and so on. I will attach this script to the description of this video. You will be able to download and use it or modify it in some way. I hope the video was useful to you. Thank you for your attention. Goodbye, everyone.